Hello, boys and girls. How are we doing?
Hello.
How are we? Apologies for the late start. Oh, I'm sure I'll tell you all about the late start as we get into this. I hate technology. Welcome to the pre-stream stream. This is where the cool kids hang. Welcome along. We'll get started in a minute or two. I need to tell you about my TV first, though, because I am really stressed out with it. You know how we've spent the last 8 months trying to get internet that works, and I finally have Wi-Fi that works all the way around the house now. Remember that? Well, the moment that works and we have Wi-Fi everywhere and we're like, oh, fantastic. No more smashed TVs. No more stressing out with tech because it works now. The very day we got the internet working, Sky just decided to start being a wang. We don't have our internet with Sky. This is Sky TV I'm talking about, my Sky Q box. Firstly, the Sky Q mini box in our kitchen will not connect to the new Wi-Fi network, which is annoying, but not the end of the world. We can live without TV in the kitchen. But now the TV in the living room, the Sky box just turns itself off. In fact, it doesn't turn itself off. What it does is we're watching a TV show. Thank you for the bits, Beagles. And iMore, thank you for the sub. We'll be watching something, and then 10, 15 seconds into watching it, the screen will just lock up, and it will just stop working. What do you mean, weird feedback? Yeah, it's this. Anna's telling me I've got to turn the aircon off. No! Could you hear that? Or was it just Anna being fussy? It just stops working. And it's very frustrating. Those of you who said in the home video so you couldn't hear the aircon, if Anna can hear it over the music. What do you mean? Yeah, I've just turned it off and you're on the stream. You can't bring that in here, it's gonna loop back round. I promise you it's fixed. You're the only person who's mentioned it. Nobody else can hear it. but yeah, the Sky just keeps locking up and then we have to unplug it at the wall, plug it back in again. I'm gonna turn that back on, see if she notices. And yeah, it's just annoying. It's just really, really annoying because as soon as it locked up, of course, Andy's pulling all the wires out of the back and we can't put it back on for long enough to try and fix it because he just keeps turning it off. So now I've got Sky to deal with. It looks like we've got a broken Sky box. And also vote for my pizza in the thing that I put on Instagram that's just appeared in the chat. Need it. Basically, the way this pizza thing works, I've just put the link in the chat, or the link just went into the chat. It's a 3-round tournament, and the deeper I get into the tournament, the more they pay me. So if you vote for my pizza, I get to do the next round, and then they pay me for the next round as well. They just pay me for whatever round I'm in. So the more of you vote, the more likely I am to get paid. And, you know, I like getting paid. Anna, I know it's back. I've just turned the air conditioning back on. You're the only person who's bothering. If anyone else is bothered by the aircon being on, let me know. This is aircon discussion amnesty. If it only bothers Anna, we can leave it on. It's fine. If it's bothering the rest of you, we'll fix it. Oh, my word. Archduke Mellon, thank you very much for the sub. lots of you saying you can't hear it, can't hear it. Yeah, can we have a poll? Yeah, Scotty, do a poll just to let us know if you can hear it. Turn it. I mean, I can turn the music up a little bit so that the music drowns it out a little bit more. I can hear it. I'm wearing headphones though, but not bothered by it. Because otherwise, basically, the reason I couldn't stream much last week is because it's too hot in here. So it's either have the air conditioning on or I don't stream very much while it's hot. Sounds like a little snare drum every time you talk, but it's not bothering me. Okay, let's have a poll. If it's bothering you, then we can deal with it. If it's not, then we won't worry about it. Battle Bolt, thank you very much for the sub. Archduke Mellon's got his silver nut. Beautiful. Yeah, so we've got the poll. It looks like it's not bothering anybody, so we should be okay. Should we get into the game as well? Let's get into the game. Stop the count. Well, I mean, I don't mind turning it off every now and again. It's just, it was 18 degrees in here. I turned it off for a few minutes. It's already back up to 21. It gets up to like 30 degrees in here, even at this time of day. It's ridiculous how hot it gets in here quickly. So we need to figure out a way to get it working. But this does confirm for everyone who said in the YouTube video today, I couldn't hear it, Kev, just leave it on. I absolutely know it's there. And I'm not gonna have it on when I'm doing videos, which is why I won't be, well done. Anna's saying, you're unwatchable now. Anna, look at the poll. Look at the chat, Anna. Anna, come in here. I can't believe it. She's so fussy. Come on, Anna, in you come. Apparently, Past Kev wanted to sign this guy, so who am I to say we shouldn't? Just voted for Meat Feast, even though I don't eat meat. Ah, excellent. Yeah, they asked me if I wanted a vegan pizza, and I said, not a chance. I want to win. No one's going to vote for a vegan pizza. Give me the most popular one. Thank you. Come in here without your phone on. Natural light looks great. You should use that lighting more often. Oh God, absolutely not. Hate it. I like to have that dark background. Even with this, your audio still sounds better than 99% of streamers. What I need to do is actually be able to hear it myself, just so I can judge if it's bad. So what I might do is jump onto my own Twitch and turn the aircon off and listen to it and see if it bothers me. She's not going to come in now. So let's turn this off. Turn music off. We're doing an experiment. We're having a listen. You know what? That bothers me. That really bothers me. How is that not bothering you? Like,
doing an experiment, we're having a listen.
Yeah, I'm putting the fan on. We're gonna leave the air conditioning off. What it means is I'm gonna have to buy Anna a Dyson fan, because I promised her when I got the air conditioning that she could have my Dyson fan. But there's no way I can stream for 3 hours without that or that. So I'll have to buy her a fan as well, so I can keep my fan and my air conditioning, because the air conditioning lowers the temperature of the room so it's usable. The fan will keep it lower while I'm streaming. Oh, there you go. We've sorted it now. Anna, come here. Don't know why she's not coming in. Right, I need to work out who's signed who. Yeah, Con is fine. I'm too much of a pro to go with fine. I'm gonna have to buy you a fan. Come in. Because the situation we've got now is, if I can't stream with this on, I have to have this on. So I need this to lower the room down during the day when it's really, really hot, but I need this to stream. So bearing in mind these two things are roughly the same price, for the living room, would you like a fan or an aircon?
A fan. Noise.
You want a fan? Okay, I'll get you a Dyson fan then. You want the big one like mine? The little personal one. You're speaking very quietly.
Of course, Kevin. Come. You only buy stuff for yourself. You never think of me.
She says, as I'm asking her if she wants a fan or an air conditioner.
Why are you shouting? I'm not here.
Because I like people to be able to hear. Can you believe it? How do you mean I only buy stuff for me? I've just offered to...
You?
I bought two of them.
When you said one was for the living room, then you took it to the kitchen.
Right.
Then,
hold on.
Then,
no.
Then you
no.
Said, give me the fan.
No. I need a mute button for you. I need to have this on record. I bought two air conditioners, one for this room, one for the living room. And Anna told me it's hotter in the kitchen, I should take it up there, and she'd have my fan. So that's what I did. I'm buying you a fan. There'll be a fan here in 2 days. You can have the air conditioner from the kitchen for 2 days.
I can't watch one.
No, I've turned it off and got the fan on. Fine. Yeah, but 97% of people disagreed with both of us. I had to test it and listen to it myself and thought, yeah, actually, that is horrible. It's horrible. We fixed it, though.
That's why I couldn't watch.
Well, you can watch now. I've turned it off.
You know what might be noises?
I know. It's fixed.
I'm right.
Yeah, and I'll buy you a... So you want the personal Dyson fan? You don't want the big one?
No,
Send me a link to the one you want and I'll see what I can sort out. My girlfriend would love my t-shirt, Anna. Anna, can we have your shirt first? Icon Dan's girlfriend. Where did you get that shirt? Is that the one I gave you? It's a QWERTY one, I think. Link somewhere on my YouTube. Ah, there we go, boys and girls. Sorted.
I was right.
Yeah, but this lot were all wrong. Everyone's saying it was unnoticeable. I could really hear it. You only hear the aircon because it's so close to the mic. It's the only place in the room it can go. And it's not actually that close to the mic at all. It's about a meter away. That needs posting. That's a shirt. I know, it needs posting. If Ryan's watching, that home shirt, I still haven't posted it. We need to get that posted. Yeah, it's about a meter away. It can't go any further away because it has to be next to the window. It's not blowing over the microphone. It's that it's a noise that close to the microphone. I can potentially have a fiddle with the Go XLR settings tomorrow. See if we can set up a better noise gate.
I do like fiddling.
Because I need everything to be right. We've lived here 8 months and it's still not all right the way it was at the old house. And it's frustrating. Matt V. Duxo, who the hell are you and why are you being sold out from under me? Do we use this guy? Yeah, we used him 12 times. What? We're in the top division and we're having a player sold out from under me for 12 grand. It's not Tuesday. He gets water on Tuesday. Jack the Cactus. I did have an aircon in the garage as well, but it was about 4 meters away then, so you couldn't hear it. I don't have four... There you go, they're showing Jack. They've seen Jack before. He is prickly, he's a cactus. I don't have 4 meters of office now. Shall I resign because of this? We'll protest the transfer and see what happens. Reconsider selling him. The club's not currently awash with funds. Yeah, but 18 grand's not going to make a difference. Goodness me. So we're losing one of our best players. For those of you who are new to this, this has been a very disjointed start to the stream. If you're watching this back on YouTube, goodness me. Goodness me, you've turned it off by now. But we got promoted last year. It was our first... We started unemployed. We ended up in Belarus managing Smorgon. We got promoted at the first time of asking... But, oh, I thought that was you leaving. You're still there. I thought you'd just walked out. Bye, Anna. And now it's the summer and we're trying to build a team that can stay up, which is probably going to be easier said than done. We're just trying to strengthen in all positions. As players get scouted in, if they look good enough to sign, we're signing them because... Contrary to what the board would have you believe, based on selling a player for 18 grand, we are awash with funds. We've got a 31 grand transfer budget. I want to say to the board, take the transfer budget away and let me keep my player. I don't want to spend 31 grand. I probably won't spend 31 grand. Let me keep... You can have 18 grand out of that. Sorted. But we've got loads of wage budgets. So we're just going to bring players in as they appear better than what we've got. I have no idea how good we need to be to stay up in this league. We've got lots of 3.5 and 4-star players in this team, but that's based on a 1.5-star reputation, and I just don't know if it's going to be good enough to stay up. So we'll figure it out. Woopoo Becky, thank you very much for the sub. You don't need to water a cactus. According to the instructions, you need to give it a little bit of water every now and again. So I give it a little dribble every Tuesday. If you don't water it at all, it'll die. Can't just not water him. That's disastrous. We're starting higher than Wales this time. I don't know. Is it higher than Wales? Is Belarus higher than Wales? Lower league misses Weymouth logic being applied by the board. Yep. Right. So we've got this guy on trial. Do we need a right back? In fact, we just got a lot of players in on trial. We have, so we'll have a look at them all together. Apparently, our financial position isn't strong enough to renew any of these contracts, so we'll just leave them as they are for now. We'll see if we can get any more trialists in off this recruitment meeting, and then we'll have a look to see what we've got knocking about the place. I think that's my plan. Get lots of trialists in, and then do this lower league style, even though we're in the top league now. Did I say I was going to get this club to Champions League glory in 15 years? It feels like it might take a little longer. I don't remember a pollen being this rubbish when we hit the top flight in Greece. And that took longer than 15 years. I might have bitten off more than I can chew here. We need money. We need to qualify for Europe quick and start getting some money into the club. Because remember what we had with Apollon is we saved the club early on by selling Ryan Lawson for 5 million and then loaning him back forever. That's what we need. We need to sell someone for 5 million, not 18,000 for our best young player. It's a different world. Right, let's get all these trials in. Presumably you can't hear the fan that's now working. I had a cacti indoors for about 6 years, never watered it, and it's still fine. Interesting. What advice do you give to teams that you've managed, such as Apollon? What do you mean, what advice do I give to them? I'm not sure what you mean. Oh, what, Dave? Okay. What's he doing? Anna's fallen out with Dave. It's been a stressful week. Half term is always a stressful week. We're back from our holiday and now we're trying to recover. The holiday we had last week.
That wasn't a holiday, that was
That's what you should have said on the video we made about it that's coming out tomorrow. Torture. It wasn't torture. She's so dramatic. No, I don't want dramatic. I want the opposite of dramatic. How many foreign players are we allowed? What's the matter? What are you huffing about now? What's the matter, Anna? Do you have something to get off your chest? You want to get me off your chest? Yeah, we do need a holiday. So we're allowed 5 foreign players in our playing 11. So how many of these are foreign?
You should call them international.
They're not internationals. International is a different thing.
No.
But it is. Of course you can say foreign.
No, you say international.
But international would mean they've played international football. They're not internationals, they're foreign.
They're in new international
play. Contact Miles and tell him on Twitter. TPP, thank you very much for the sub. We're not allowed to call them foreign players, according to Anna. How many leagues are loaded? We had loads loaded. Quite a few of these are going to fall off as we hit the end of it, like midway through our season, as we hit the end of the season in the rest of Europe. We've got a weird league. Right, at the moment, we don't have any foreign players. So if we're allowed 5, let's not sign more than 5. We want Conan. Let's get this guy, Fabrice Conan, to be our creative spark in midfield. He can have all the money that he wants to have because his name's Conan, which is brilliant. If you need to watch not to sign more than 5 foreign players because you pay extra money for them. What? What do you mean you pay extra money for them? Where am I looking? Where does it say about this in the rules? Oh, here we go. A registration fee will be payable for registered foreign players. So 5 registered players are free. But the 6th player would be 5 grand. And then what? Wow, okay. That is... So we can't just get loads of foreign players. This is going to be great. So Conan would be our first. Let's just do 5 then. That's all we can afford at the moment. So who's the next best player on this list? And is he foreign? Kolodinsky is Belarusian. So we'll sign him. Because he's not foreign. Once you get into Europe, those fees are pretty insignificant. Yeah, they need to be. In the Dutch leagues, where there's a higher minimum wage. Is it the Dutch leagues where there's a higher minimum wage for non-EU? Is there? Wow. Right. Let's... I'm not even negotiating these deals. We've got loads of money. It'll be fine. Ivan Veras is also Belarusian, so we'll sign him. Just chuck all these players in. We'll have them all. Vaskov is Belarusian and old. We don't really want an old man. You couldn't get into Gommel's team last year. Because do we still have to have a certain number of young players as well? I know that was a thing last year. Must be at least one Belarusian under 21 player in the playing 11. Okay, so we've got to make sure. Have we got a good under 21 Belarusian player or two who might get near the team? Duxo's the one. That's why we really can't let Duxo go. We're gonna have to play absolute trash. Right. Keon Daniel. I'm not going to get a 34-year-old as one of my foreign players, no matter how good he is. He's not good enough, especially for a foreign player. We'll get this guy, though. Alexei Savchenko. Mainly because he's 20. And it's just handy to have more younger players, so we'll bring him in. He's 34, but much better than what we've got in goal. He's 26 and has got loads of under 21 appearances. He played for Smorgon before. So at one point, presumably, he was the future of Belarusian goalkeeping. Whereas this guy never was. So we go with the guy who's the future. No, we don't. We go with the one who's better, I think. Do we go with either of them? We go with it. Who was he playing for last year? He played a few games in this league last year. So we're going to bring this guy in. Magic. Right, let's see what my director of football's got for me on free transfers as well. Hopefully some young players. That's what we're looking for. We need all of the young players. These all look like old men. This is ridiculous. Why are they all old men? Have we all voted for our pizza? Now all the shenanigans done. Got to go and vote for Magnificent Meat Feast to get Kev more magnificent pizza money. Win some free pizza for yourself. Exclamation mark pizza. If you want to find out more. None of these are young. Well, that was good. Wasn't it just? Just seen your tweet about your skybox. There's a setting where you can turn on so the box does not go into eco mode. What eco mode is? I don't think eco mode is what's happening. It's just locking up. I think, to be honest, I think it's probably overheating. This looks like a fun league to be in. Do you have good club finances? Oh no! Oh no! 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 It's all going to go very badly wrong. Try to raid the second division of Belarus. Go check season preview of the second tier. Oh, that would make me such a cheating monster. But I might. I might just do that. Do we want a Hungarian striker? Probably not. What have we got that's been scouted? I don't really remember how much detail we were going into the other night on these players, but... Like, these ones who are near the top of this, if they're available for free, should probably be coming in on trial. Like, all of these guys should be getting trials for sure. And all of these guys. Get all of the trials in. Right, so we're cheating. There's nobody on non-contracts. I don't really want to pay money for any of them just in case. I mean, he's a 30-year-old midfielder who's in the team as a striker. I don't think there's much that's any good in that league below. Let's concentrate on the ones who are available for free and hope they're not currently serving suspensions for match fixing. Like half the players we tried to sign last season were. If you had a regen, you could play centre forward. Would you use him as a centre forward in 4-2-3-1 or use him as... I don't know. Depends what system I want to play, I guess. Before you go to bed, turn off the Sky Q at the mains for the night. Yeah, we did that last night. Thought that would get the job done. It didn't. It lasted about 15 seconds today before it just turned itself off again. I think they just need to fix it. They need to come out soon and fix it. Right, check the next batch of trialists who are in then. So, Sidorenko, who is a target man. You know I love a target man this year. We might bring him in. Unless they're going to be the best player in their position, I don't think we're bringing in foreign players. I think we're going Belarusian. Unless we absolutely have to look at somewhere else. I like the look of this guy, though. We already offered this guy a deal? No. Well, now we'll rectify that and offer him a deal. See, this guy is a much better option in goal. He used to play for Tom as well, so he must be good. I'm going to offer this guy the goalkeeper job. He's 38, but he only has to do it for a year. Jerome, thank you very much for the sub. So a 38-year-old goalkeeper, and then we are going to offer Sidorenko a contract as well. And then we're going to check on finances. And we've still got loads of money left to play with. Right. So we want him. Hooray! At least we're not having to send them on language courses because they all speak... Is Belarusian a language or do they speak Russian? Or what's their deal in Belarus? What language do they speak? Yeah, the box may need to update. It happened to mine, then I found the solution on the Q box. Holding the button that lights up green or orange, depending on if it's on or standby. Unplug it, but keep holding the button in. When it comes back on, it will update itself and should fix it. The problem is it's not connected to the internet. Because we've set up a new network. So I'm not sure how it would update itself. I need to just sit and have a proper fiddle with it, which I'll do after this stream. I can't really do that with Andy around, which is the problem. Both Belarusian and Russian are official languages. Well, there we go. Hydrate, I shall. Oh, lovely, lovely, lovely. Contact Nerdphonic again. Well, I did originally have him booked in to come out on Wednesday. I don't know if he's much of a TV repairman, though. It was going to come out and sort my Wi-Fi for me. But I've sorted that myself now, but... A few people have suggested on Twitter that the Wi-Fi might be what's broken it. So because the Sky Q system wants to be a mesh, and I've now got the Asus AI mesh and a TP-Link Deco mesh, we've got meshes for days. They might be clashing with each other, and it's just breaking the Sky, which is why Sky can't connect. So this is our first foreign player, Fabrice Konen, who was at Gommel last year, apparently. Actually, was that last year? Because they were in our league last year. He was at Gommel 3 years ago. He's been in prison for the last few years, it seems. Tell me he's not on a match-fixing ban. No, that's all right then. How much is a language course going to cost? $9,000? Not a chance. He's been in Belarus before. What, does he speak any? How does he not speak a word of Russian or Belarusian when he's been here? He's played... forgotten the language. Never mind. That Duxo, is Duxo left? That's... Hold on. So we have an assistant manager slash technical director called Duxo. Is that the dad of the Duxo that we're... that's being sold out from under me? Now I understand. He's just letting his boy have whatever move he wants. My assistant manager slash boss... How does that work? He's my assistant, but also technical director. How is that a thing? This is a broken, broken system in this country. The Shadow Demon, thank you very much for the sub. 12 months. Lovely, lovely, lovely. The update will be trying to apply itself, but for some reason it doesn't, so it should already be loaded up and good to go. I will give that a bash. Can you tweet those instructions at me so I remember it after the stream, so I remember exactly what I have to do? Posture check. There we go. Have I thought of raiding the national team? I haven't. We'll worry about that at a later date, probably. Don't know why I just lifted that in such an unusual manner.
Cheers.
It's a cup of coffee. Right, apparently we're trying to take a guy on loan. I'm not against it. I'll allow loans to happen. My name on Twitter isn't Daft, by the way. It's Liam Campbell. That's fine. I'll notice the instructions and figure out that it's you. What the heck? I'm in a journeyman save and I've been appointed as Nottingham Forest manager. Lads gave me a transfer budget of 92 million. Well, that's what we learnt with Sheffield United. There's a lot of money knocking about in the championship on FM21. You get a few years deep, championship's loaded with money. Almost to the point where it's worth reporting as a bug. There shouldn't be that much money in the championship. Kenny Cage, thank you for the sub. What the heck do I do with 92 million? Spend 300. We had 75, I think, when we went into Sheffield United in the championship, and 4 years later won the Champions League. So go spend. Right, well, Matvey Duxo has gone to Minsk because his dad made it happen. No, it's literally his dad handling it. Idiots. The one young player we were going to have. Not happy. This is my not happy face. Right. NordVPN. That's great, isn't it? NordVPN. I mentioned they've renewed for another 2 months. Happy days. Thank you to everyone who signed up with them. That's the second time they've renewed with me. So we're obviously doing something right. We did a 1 month contract initially. They extended that for whatever it's been now, 3 or 4 months, which expired at the end of May, 1st of June. Can we do a couple more months, Kev? Yes, absolutely. You can do a couple more months. Help yourself. So thank you to everyone who signed up for that. Keeping me in food and stuff, mugs, Diet Coke, keeping Facebook at bay. Oh dear. It is still their birthday. They haven't sent me a new thing to replace that with yet. The bloody night. Thank you very much for the 6 month streak. Beautiful. You might want to have a look. Your nuts changed color. Do I still have an affiliate link for Manscaped? I don't know if it will still work at this point. You can try it. It's probably still on a command. I don't know if it will still work at this point because we did that quite a while ago. But by all means, try it. Can you remember the reputation of home when you got promoted to the Prem for the first time? No, not off the top of my head. I've just been called a scum mug. Oh, too thick to have a go at somebody properly. I love that. That's going right up there with Idoit. We've got Idoit and scum mug. Oh my word. Hashtag scum mug. How do you change ranges from per annum to per week? I think it's in the settings somewhere. Isn't a scum mug something that's been left outside too long? I don't know, I've never heard of a scum mug before. Hashtag scum mug. Might do scum mug t-shirts. God, can I even say that username? Numpty Defiler, thank you very much for your Prime sub. I could shut the curtains, the blinds, now that I've turned the air conditioning off. Everyone's furious. What the hell have I just done? What the hell have I just done to make everybody furious? Whoops. Whoops. So they didn't like the code of conduct. The code of conduct has made them furious. I feel like there's more important things for them to worry about. But at least we've broken all of this before the season starts. Oh dear. Right, one moment. Get the hose in. And then... Oh, there you go. Back in darkness. Oh, much better. Much better. Love the darkness. Code of conduct was too lenient. I don't understand. I don't have anything to do with the code of conduct. I just let the other... I've never had it be a problem. I've got other staff to deal with stuff like that. That's not even my concern. Talking of things that are my concern, did we play a 4-2-3-1 last year? Or was it just defaulted to this? I assume we did. Basically said, we'll fine you less. In a country full of match fixing, just having a code of conduct offends them. Maybe it does. Right. We've got another scout coming in. Lovely. Right, so I think we've just signed a bunch of players. We've still got loads of money left. But how's the team looking? Who are you? We don't need to use a foreign player for a position we've already got lots of cover for. Although he's good in multiple options. He's too old.
Three more.
Three more what? Why do we need three air conditioners? Do you want air conditioners or fans? The kitchen is lovely and cool now, yeah. So do you want air conditioners or fans? But yeah. I won't order anything now. You tell me what you want and then I'll order it. Oh my word. Kev, is the Charlotte teams and the Bourne the same teams? Ah, there's loads of Charlotte teams in the Bourne save. I'm not sure. Been a while, is Sheffield done? It is. We won the Champions League. Therefore, job done. Get her a hot tub full of ice cubes. But then it would be a cold tub, surely. Hello, LOLLUJO. I'm sweating like a biscuit. How's the stream been so far? Do biscuits sweat? Do biscuits sweat? I've never seen a sweaty biscuit. How does a biscuit sweat? It was like a lead into a joke. Then he gets soggy. Well, they would get... So this fullback's not any good. But he's young, so we might end up using him anyway, because we need young players. We've got to have that one under 21 player in every squad. Club unhappy. Well, you're unhappy because you're a bunch of pillocks. Murmurs of discontent. They're expressionless. Fantastic. I agree something needs to be done. Yeah, let's pump the fist. I can't pump the fists. What's the one that pacifies? There you go. I've satisfied them. I've satisfied a room full of expressionless Belarusian men. That's another t-shirt for you. Does the aircon have to be by a window? Yeah. What am I planning to celebrate 100k? Nothing. It's like, we hit 100k. Celebrating's for losers. I just want the tick and the plaque. And the fact brand deals will start at 100k. Although I've got two brand deals on the LOLLUJO channel this week. Three if you count the Chicago Town thing, but they didn't want that on YouTube. That was, they didn't need it in a video, so I've not put it in a video. Why would we... Didn't we just sign this guy? No. Okay, well, then we could get rid of him because he's not good enough. So we've got a couple of brand deals coming up this week. So we are starting to attract interest to keep the wolves from the door again. Always good. Are you going to do a special short save for reaching 100k? No. I'm already doing two saves on YouTube. I need to drop one of them. I need one of them to finish so I can go down to... There's no way long term, it is not sustainable for me to do two YouTube saves, one Twitch save, and a pretty much daily vlog. Something's got to drop. So the thing that's going to drop is one of the YouTube saves as soon as it's possible to drop one of them. I won't stop either of them midway through, but as soon as one of them finishes, they're not getting replaced. 400 subs away from 100k. So close. What happened to Dynamics? I upset the boys. What were the words on today's t-shirt on the videos? I don't know, what t-shirt was I wearing? Was it this t-shirt? Which is my Not the Mama t-shirt. Hate that you can't record videos with a fan and window open and lights on. Yeah. How many subs for me to do a hot tub stream? If we get to 800 subs on Twitch, I'll do a hot tub stream. 800 subs equals full-time Twitch streamer. That's when, if we get to 800 subs, I'll start doing more than two or three streams a week. Because then it's paying me full-time money. At the moment, it's part-time money, so I stream part-time. We get to 800 subs consistently. That's full-time money, so I'll stream more often. And I'll do a hot tub stream to kick it off. And when I say a hot tub stream, I'll buy a paddling pool and stream in that for like 20 minutes. I'm not buying a hot tub. The Bourne save isn't going to end anytime soon. We don't know how hard it's going to be the further up we get. We don't know how hard the top flight's going to be. It's all uncharted territory in the Bourne save. So it's been very difficult climbing up to the top, but once we get to the top, you know, we've never done a promotion and not been in the top three straight away. So it might be like that all the way through. It might be difficult to climb up, but relatively simple to move around within a league. I don't know how much money floats around at the top end, but it could be that we could be there within six or seven seasons. We could have won everything. We don't know. Am I going to do an England Euro save? No, everyone's doing them. So what's the point in it? I mean, who wants to see that, really? Do you want to see 10 different creators all do the same save? I figured not. Oh, dear. My drink went down the wrong hole. This is not good. Oh, a 19-year-old centre-back on loan. That's handy. Is he Belarusian? Yes, there you go. We can play him. That's how... Oh, he was at Foreign Arsenal last year. Crack him. Not allowed to say foreign, though, according to Anna. Turn me off. Why am I touching my face so much in this stream? I've not let go of my... It's like I'm holding my beard on. What is going on? Right, let's get all these boys in the squad. When's the season start? It's so difficult to know if this team's going to be good enough. So our best player is still Ivanov. We have no concept of whether he's going to be good enough for this league, though. We're supposed to finish second bottom. We obviously have no one anywhere near the Dream 11. Because they're all players for those two big clubs. Wouldn't you reach full-time money faster if you were streaming full-time? I don't particularly want to stream full-time. It's not a case of... I want to be a full-time streamer. It's more a case of, if it starts paying me full-time money, then my way of thanking everybody and rewarding everybody for that would be to stream full-time. It's not a case of I'm going to stream full-time to try and get full-time money, because I already earn my money doing YouTube videos. Apparently, sound levels have hit 90 decibels in my office. That feels wrong. I think my Apple Watch is on the fritz. There's no way it's 90 decibels in this room. Unless I'm talking very, very loud, which I don't think I am. Streamer Showdown National Team Edition. Suggest it to Ben, I don't know. Jack has done it reasonably by using what he would have chosen. Yeah, so I can't now go and do the same thing. Because I couldn't tell you who I'd choose in real life. I'd just do it based on Football Manager, because I don't know anything about real life football. I've watched the last two England friendlies, and a lot of those players, I was seeing them play for the first time. I'd never seen them play a game of football before. So I'm not really in a position to say this is the team I would take in real life. I've seen a lot of Ben White when he was at Posh, so he can be captain. What's my opinion on the YouTube boxing that happened last night? I don't really have an opinion on it. It was fixed, wasn't it? Is what I heard. How many subs would you need to replace YouTube entirely? I wouldn't replace YouTube entirely. YouTube will always be my main thing. Ooh, another youngster coming in on loan. Cracking. Yeah, YouTube's too important, especially because looking 3 or 4 years down the line, YouTube will still be around, Twitch maybe not. So YouTube will always be the number one priority, he says, talking to his Twitch audience. How to endear yourself to people. But to, in all seriousness, to fully replace YouTube, several thousand subs. I earn far more out of YouTube than I do from Twitch. I had to quit my gym due to the shoulder problem. Also, may never be able to work physically again. Yikes. What is the shoulder problem you've got? Is it diagnosed or just ongoing? What's the situation? Mayweather knocked him out and then never let him fall. Wow. What's the goal with the Belarusian team? Win the Champions League. Is there much of a skill difference between League Two and One? What, in Belarus or in England? Because I don't know. Why will Twitch die in a few years? Because there's no discoverability. They're turning into a porn site. And YouTube and Facebook will catch up and then take over when it comes to streaming stuff. All you need is them to add clips and raids and gifted subs to YouTube and Facebook and have Google and Facebook continue to throw money and continue to use the fact they've got discovery algorithms that Twitch don't. And before too long, everything that is unique and important and makes Twitch the place to stream, if you can get the same streaming experience everywhere, then you'd be better off on one of the sites that gives you that better discoverability and more people will find you because they have an algorithm. Twitch needs a recommended page. It needs an algorithm. As much as people complain about the YouTube algorithm, it's what we've all used to grow. You don't get anywhere just from sub boxes. George, thank you very much for the sub. YouTube are working on an update to the streaming side soon, according to my sources. Yeah, they've been working on one for a long time. Yeah, once YouTube fully catch up and fully commit to streaming, I think we all move to YouTube and pretty soon we forget Twitch exists. We'll never get the same experience. Twitch culture is different. Yeah, but who cares what the culture is when no one's here? Vine culture was great. MySpace culture was brilliant. But as soon as everybody leaves, it doesn't matter anymore, does it? And the same thing will happen to Twitch. It's severe scoliosis in my left shoulder, had since birth. Oh, okay. I don't really know what that means. It sounds sore. Amazon owns Twitch. It's not going anywhere. I'm not saying Twitch is going to go out of business. I'm saying Twitch is going to become irrelevant. I'm not going to lie, YouTube live streams are nightmares in terms of the chat. Yeah, because they've not caught up yet, but they will. Kev, are you asking for Twitch to ban me? If they're dumb enough to ban me, then I just go to YouTube and just stream there where I've got a bigger audience. If they ban, I mean, that would say it all, wouldn't it? Imagine if they banned me for talking about the website. Talk about a dictatorship. If they banned me for that, that would confirm and clarify everything I'm talking about. So I don't think there's much fear of that. Facebook will never catch up. I also don't think YouTube will. YouTube will always be primary video and Twitch primary streaming. We'll see, I guess. We will see. But I speak to a lot of other creators and we're all of a similar sort of mind that within a few years we'll probably be streaming on YouTube. I think that's ultimately where everybody ends up. We shall see, though. There's a reason we've not gone yet, because at the moment, Twitch is still the best place. It's just trying to read the tea leaves and guess where the future's going. I think anybody who just does Twitch and doesn't have a YouTube presence that they're also building up is making a big mistake, partly because you need that YouTube presence to build your Twitch, because there's no discoverability on Twitch. But also, if and when Twitch does become irrelevant, at least then you've got your YouTube audience that's already there. I mean, ultimately, if I had to start streaming on YouTube tomorrow, I've got nearly 100,000 people there who are ready to start watching those streams. I'd get more viewers there than I do here. I'd just make less money there at the moment because it's complicated. Don't get Facebook gaming. Can't see the point in it. Most people don't have Facebook. I mean, you know that's not true, though, don't you? You know far more people have Facebook than Twitch. I'm assuming you do know that. What you mean is most people you know don't use Facebook very much. Which is a very, very different sentence. I mean, I have a Facebook. I've not logged into it for a long time, but I have Facebook. YouTube could catch up if they wanted to. They just need to be bothered about it. And from the discussions I've had with them and from the stuff you hear on the grapevine, they're going to be making plays. Facebook profiles aren't anonymous, which may turn some viewers away. Equally, it might draw some creators in. And there's talk of Facebook allowing anonymous profiles on the gaming side of things. Who's my favorite small FM creator? Surely if they're small, I won't have heard of them. Define small. Give me a list and I'll tell you who's my favorite out of the list. I'll tell you if I've heard of them. I think we'll likely get a new fully streaming platform as it doesn't make YouTube as much money as videos. But it will once they add in all of the revenue streams that Twitch has. YouTube needs to bring in free subs with premium like Twitch with Prime. Agreed. I also think YouTube need to make it so that if you're a channel member, you don't get adverts on that channel. I think that would be a big thing. I think they need to bring in raids and clips and integrate YouTube Shorts within... Why are we getting cash injections? Integrate YouTube Shorts within the streaming platform and use it for stream highlights. I think YouTube don't have to do very much to become a huge problem for Twitch. Under 500 subs. What, under 500 YouTube subs? I don't think I could name anyone who's got less than 500 YouTube subs. I'm not Dr. Benji. I'm not scouting people for the showdown all the time. I don't really watch Football Manager content. Chances are, unless someone's been in the showdown, I probably don't know they exist. Josh Peach is small. There you go. Josh Peach, then. I like Josh Peach. Josh is good. Makes very good content. Should be doing more YouTube stuff, which I've told him. Because if he wants to grow, he needs to grow on YouTube and then send those people to Twitch. Can't grow on Twitch. He won't listen, though, the little rascal. Claims he's too busy with his real job. Which I suppose is acceptable. If that was the case, I'd bin off the streaming altogether and just do YouTube, grow the audience over there, because then it's easy to move them to Twitch. It's much harder to move nobody to YouTube. Tom FM is my favorite small creator. How many subs has Tom got these days? Does he count as small anymore? I don't even know how many subs he's got. Clips are on their way on YouTube. They're not available for all channels yet. I don't have clips on my channels. But yeah, clips is going to be a huge thing for YouTube streaming. Is Anna my favourite streamer under 5 foot? She would claim she's not under 5 foot. Right, we're still not going to sign that guy. A lot of these players were here before the last time we got trials in. So I think we're probably going with this team. I don't want to bring in old men. We've signed a lot of players this... Keep wanting to call it a summer, but it's not the summer, is it? It's winter. Are we going to actually have to go through... I mean, we're losing friendlies as well. This is such a big problem. Oh, no. What is happening? 27k. I don't think 27k is small, is it? Although it depends. I mean, in the grand scheme of YouTube, anything less than a million is still pretty small. I don't think there's anyone. There's certainly no one making Football Manager content. It was a big creator, I don't think. For me, YouTube need to run their stream like Twitch do with their speeds. And have ads taken out. Keep the chat speeds like Twitch. Run their stream like Twitch do with their speeds. What do you mean by their speeds? I'm not sure what you mean by the speeds. Because you can stream in 4K at higher, you can stream at a higher resolution on YouTube than you can on Twitch. Twitch limits you to 1080p. Do you get ads in the middle of live streams on YouTube? I don't know that you do. You do on Twitch sometimes. If you could only watch one creator ever again, who would it be? Probably Wrestle Talk, because I watch them every day for my wrestling news. Will there be a vlog recorded on the 10th of July? No idea. Let's not worry. Good to see some of the big FIFA guys like Manny and Kurt playing FM2. Hopefully their viewers turn into FM streamers. Hopefully. That was your cue to play an ad. I know. So you don't get ads in streams on YouTube. So I don't know what the point that was being made before was. You can stream in higher quality on YouTube and there's no adverts. You only get adverts on the replays, which you get on Twitch as well, don't you? I mean, the great thing is, similar to with all these, what's best? Sega, Nintendo, PlayStation, Xbox. You don't have to choose. You can use both. Just try YouTube streaming for 1 week. I would suggest I've streamed more on YouTube than any other Football Manager creator. I streamed on YouTube for a long time. I've probably done as many YouTube streams as I have Twitch streams. The reason I'm on Twitch now is the Streamer Showdown. Simple as that. Ever watch Quizlemania? No, I don't have time for Quizlemania. It's not in the evenings, isn't it? And I'm usually streaming in the evenings. Can you manually run an ad? I could. No point though, because it doesn't really pay anything. It just annoys you lot without really paying me anything. Yeah, I used to stream on YouTube a lot. FM Trek has streamed more on YouTube than me. Prove it. How many years has he done it for? I reckon I've probably got 2 years of YouTube streams. Has he done it for more than 2 years? Several times a week? If he has, then fair enough. I think you're forgetting just how much I used to stream on YouTube. The stream replay ads pay much? No. On Twitch, ads are basically nothing. I can tell you. Hold on. I can tell you how much I made in ads last month on Twitch. It's basically nothing. I say I can tell you. I don't know where to find it. I don't really know my way around the analytics page. Right, last month, ads paid me $49 for the month on Twitch. $49. You don't play ads. That's because you're a sub, so you don't see them. If you weren't a sub, there'd be ads. YouTube needs to have channel points like Twitch do, then creators. I mean, you can do all that through Stream Elements still. It doesn't have to be a Twitch. Remember, that was all on Streamlabs and Stream Elements before Twitch stole the idea and started doing it themselves. Doesn't help that basically all your Twitch viewers are subscribers. I mean, it does help in so much as subscribers pay me a lot more than adverts ever would. Was the YouTube streaming when you were banned from Twitch as a teacher? No. It was long before that. Is it the subs where most money comes from on Twitch? Yeah. But Twitch do take a big cut of it. Which is another advantage of YouTube, because YouTube take a much smaller cut. I make much more. I make I reckon there's some months where I make more from my channel members on YouTube, and there's only about 200 of them, than I do from 400 Twitch subs. Because of the huge cut that Twitch take. Really enjoyed your episode of the Scouting Centre with Diz. Thank you very much. Glad you enjoyed it. Don't Facebook take no cut at the moment? I don't really know how Facebook works. I've not really looked into it. We've talked before about me and Facebook and what it would take for me to take to even start looking into them. So I don't really know. What's the benefits of channel membership? You get to pay the creator money. Same as the benefits of being a sub on Twitch. It's just a way to support the creator, isn't it, really? I mean, you've got little bits in there, like you have access to emotes and you can see different parts of the community page. And it's, I mean, it's little bits and bobs, but it's basically YouTube's version of being a Twitch sub. What would it take? Massive sack of cash. Like a stupid amount of money. They've rejected our offer. They'd have to offer me double what I earn on Twitch. And I don't just mean what I earn from Twitch. You include the sponsorships and stuff on there. So you have to bundle in everything I earn from Twitch subs, the Nord sponsorship, the Raid sponsorships, any other sponsorships that I've done, bundle it all together, work out what that is on average each month, at least double it, and then we'd start talking. That's what it would take. Zuckerberg said they won't take a penny from creators until 2023. Interesting. Sounds like they're making a big, big play into gaming streaming, which is interesting. Right, the transfer deadline has passed. We're going to get into some games soon. On paper, it looks like a good squad. We've got lots of high star ratings in there. The only problem is team cohesion is done. Club atmosphere, at least, has gone back up a bit. Everyone's calmed down a little bit. But team cohesion, because we brought in so many players, team cohesion is ruined. We brought in those two as well. So that's two plus. We've signed 14 players this winter. Still got loads of money left. 14 new signings. We've wrecked team cohesion. Click the join button on YouTube. It tells you the benefits. There you go. Are you still doing much with Patreon? I mean, the Patreon's there. Out of every way you can directly support me as a creator, Patreon take the smallest cut by a mile. So the best thing to do is Patreon when it comes to making sure more of your money gets to me. I don't really talk about it very much because I don't have any Patreon benefits or perks or anything. You don't get anything from being part of my Patreon. And it's an extra step. It's inconvenient for people to do. So in my experience, like, I've got more YouTube channel members than I've ever had Patreon backers. So I think just the fact it's there and it's one button and it's all on the same platform, it's just convenient. So for me, it makes sense to push the stuff that more people are likely to do rather than the one that a few people might do and I'll get a bigger cut from, but ultimately not many people are going to do it. So the Patreon's there for people who want to go and find it and want as much of their money as possible to make it into my pocket. But I don't really push it or talk about it or offer anything for it because I'm just delighted that there are people out there who are willing to give me a fiver a month, however they want to do it. I'm not going to tell them which is the best way. They do it whichever way they want to do it because it's their fiver and I'm just glad that they want to give it to me and I'm very grateful for that. And you get the thanks for support as a channel member at the start of the video. You only get that if you're in for a fiver a month or more. Not everyone who's a channel member gets that. Being a Patreon sub gives you a different color name on the Discord. There you go. In fact, all three of them give you different colors. So Patreon, Twitch sub, or YouTube channel member, they all give you access to the VIP lounge in the Discord, and you get a different color for each. I'm doing a Man United director of football save. It's quite challenging, but really fun. Director of football saves can be a nightmare, as we found about this time last year. You should mention it more, as I'm sure some channel subs would prefer that money goes to you than Google. Yeah, it's just... especially now I do a lot more brand deals. I don't mention channel memberships very much either, other than at the start of every video. I feel like I do enough brand deals and stuff to not have to constantly be asking people for money. Let brands give me money. The options are there for anyone who really, really wants to do it, but I feel uncomfortable asking for it. So I don't. Also, for teenagers, you can use Google vouchers on YouTube and Twitch, which you can't do on Patreon. There you go. Don't forget to set player roles. I'm sure we'll do a bit of that. We're facing our parent, or our former parent club. They're not our parent club anymore. But we've got lots of our new boys in. Why is Ivanov not in this team? Because he's ineligible because he's on loan from them. Of course he is. Right, Sidorenko can play advanced forward. That's fine. Most of these look like they slot straight into the roles we already had, which is useful. This all looks good to me. Let's just make sure we've got our set piece takers set up properly. Come on, use the buttons, Kev. I don't know why I bother doing this, because if I just left this alone, the game would do it for me. Sometimes you see something on it that's just obviously wrong and you take it out. But this save, I don't know the names well enough yet to know if something's obviously wrong. I don't really need to go through and do all that. I could just leave it to the game. One thing I haven't done is mentoring groups. So let's just get people into mentoring groups. And let's see how we compare to the former parent club. No idea. Not seen a Skillshare advert for a while. That's because the six-month contract I had with them on the vlog has expired. Watch this space on the LOLLUJO channel later this week. They may have decided to switch channels. Who knows? Who could speculate on such a thing? Strange how talking about money can alienate people from watching. They could just keep watching for free. I know, it's hard, isn't it? So I guess it depends on how much we like the YouTube perks, like sub-only content, and then top it up with Patreon if we really wanted. Yeah, I guess. I mean, ultimately, no one needs to get involved in doing it. If you want to do it, there's lots of ways to do it. And I appreciate all of them. But don't ever feel like you have to. Hydrate and posture at the same time. Cop blimey. Streamer Showdown Twitter page still has Clates as the current champion. Bless them. So they can say the Clates era is still going. Since you don't give us any hint, how could we possibly speculate? Exactly. I guess the brand deal on LOLLUJO will take place in between matches. I haven't decided where I'm going to put it yet. How many awful, ridiculous brand deals have you had to turn down? Loads. I mean, you've seen some of the stuff that I've done over the years, I guess. So the bar used to be pretty low. The bar's a lot higher now. I only do good stuff now. But back in the day, I did some really dodgy brand deals when I really needed the money. But now I turn down lots of them. I've turned down lots of stuff from gambling sites, terrible apps, just lots of terrible apps. You get the odd company who just absolutely try and lowball you as well. The amount of times I've had to educate brands on how much my, you know, you'll get someone who'll come in and say, I'll give you 50, I had one probably less than a year ago. $50 a month for 4 shout outs in videos over the course of the month. Yeah, all right. Yeah, all right. $50 a month. So what's that? $12.50, about 10 quid, about 10 quid an ad spot. You think I'm worth £10 an advert? Oh. Have I turned down one football? Yeah, a few times, because they're one of the ones who really don't want to pay the amount that I know I'm worth. What do you think betting ads in football games? Used to be able to just ignore them, but now they really annoy me. I feel like they should be banned. I've not noticed them in Are they in FM? I've not noticed them in FM, I don't think. Are they in FIFA? The ultimate brand deal with Disneyland Paris. I mean, that would be the perfect one. I was in very early discussions with a company, like a tour operator for Florida, like a year and a half ago. And then obviously there was a couple of travel opportunities that we had. There was one that was like a family place in Europe. That's probably as much as I can specify. So I'm hoping I can revive some of these deals when everything opens up again. But we had a week's trip that was arranged for last summer. In August, we were going to be going somewhere for a week as part of a brand deal, which obviously never happened. And then we were discussing potentially doing Florida. And they both went poo. Did I turn down Raid Shadow Legends? Nope. In fact, we've got Raid Shadow Legends coming up again later this week. Because they pay properly. Bookmakers are only allowed to advertise in TV before, during, or after a football match. Interesting. Is that actually true, or is that just when they do it? What would be my ideal partnership with a company look like? Something that just fits in organically. So, for the football manager stuff, someone who could realistically be a shirt sponsor. I mean, that the best brand deal, the best long-term sponsorship I could do at the moment would be a company come on as home shirt sponsors, actually be on the shirts for real, sponsor the entire series, and be willing to be a part of the content and work it into the storyline, similar to the Mrs. Weymouth role. Almost have someone from the sponsors who almost play that Mrs. Weymouth role. Oh, that would be perfect, because it would integrate so perfectly. But I think that's the amount of money I would want for something like that is likely to put off, because like sponsoring an entire series, having your name on the shirts for 200 plus episodes, no one's going to pay a creator my size that kind of money. Isn't Tom sponsored by One Football? No idea. Hope he managed to get more money out of them than they offered me. You're going to work yourself into a shoot with that sponsorship idea. But it would be perfect. Like, who's just said it? Like, This Really Is Me has said it wouldn't even feel like a sponsorship. Exactly. It would be perfect. I mean, let's take Chicago Town as an example, because they're the ones I've done the advert with today. If the home shirts had the Chicago Town logo on, and I had someone from Chicago Town pop up in the videos once every couple of weeks, moaning at me about how the save was going, or threatening to pull their sponsorship because things weren't going well, or if we got a mysterious soft drink sponsorship in the game, just turning up saying, "What's this soft drinks thing? You've already got pizza. What do you need soft drinks for?" Just integrating it in nicely like that, it would just make the content better. It'd be brilliant. Tom FM and Second Yellow Card both got One Football ads. Fair enough. They haven't even approached me this time, if they're doing the rounds at the moment, because I've told them to do one before. Because it was insultingly low. So I hope they got decent money out of them. Right, we're going to name a new captain here, because our current captain is at the bottom of that list. That can't be right. Okay, because it's not in any kind of order. So he's there. So he's going to lose the captaincy, because he's not going to play for us anymore. The new captain is this guy. He can stay as vice captain. Splendid. We only lost 2-1 away from home against the team that were our parent club last year. That's not too bad. I don't know if there's away goals in the Belarusian Cup. Do they have away goals? Doesn't look like there's any mention of away goals. So we've just got to try and beat them at our place. I think one football do a flat weight for channels under 100k. The rate for 100 to 250, you just happen to be at the top end of the bracket. I don't, like I say, I don't know. They've approached me a couple of times over the years. And if that's their flat rate, it wasn't enough for me when I was at 20,000 subscribers. It would have been less than any brand deal I ever did. Even like the water filter one. So yeah, not good. Once you tip over 100k, maybe a few will come in. Well, that's what happened on the vlog channel. As soon as we hit 100k, the Skillshare deal came out of nowhere. We started getting regular sponsors. Certainly when we were doing weekly videos, there was a sponsor on pretty much every one of them. So I imagine that will be the case, but it's harder to integrate with Football Manager. So there's going to be a lot more that get turned down. Because if it doesn't fit into the video, then I'm not going to do it. What's the worst ever LOLLUJO brand deal? I've done very few brand deals as LOLLUJO. So I wouldn't say there has been a bad one. The bad ones were all on the vlog channel when we were just before we went to Disneyland for the first time and we hadn't got any spending money. So I literally said yes to everything for about 3 months and every penny that came in got converted into euros and that was our spending money. We spent every penny we had on the holiday itself, had no spending money. So I just did a series of pretty iffy brand deals just for anything. I did this ear camera to clean your ears out and watch on your phone to see where the wax is, which I do still use sometimes. We did a water filter. We did a pillow that I still use every night. A weighted blanket that Andy still uses all the time. So you know what I'm saying there? We said yes to everything. A lot of these products we are still using. We don't have the water filter anymore. We did this science experiment kit. If your idea of shirt ads, it'd even work if it was just for a season or two, then you could change sponsors. Yeah, exactly. But it's such an unusual thing that I think the difficulty becomes getting it through the company. So if a company do approach me, suggesting to them that they come in as a sponsor, that they'd have to really know my content. In the same way as KFC was a really good match for the Streamer Showdown, because the person at KFC watched the Streamer Showdown, understood the product, so that way it was easy to integrate with shirt sponsors and touchline spot, like the advertising boards around the ground and all that stuff. That if you're just talking to a company who don't get what they're sponsoring, they're not going to understand any of that. They're not going to see the value in any of that. Whereas KFC got it. I don't know what any, I don't know the videos that any of these ads were on. You'd have to go and look through loads of the old daily vlogs from like the first 3 or 4 months of 2018 or 2019. When did we go to Disney? 2019? So it'd be like February to April 2019. So you're going to have to look through like 60 or 70 videos to find them all. The home of football sponsored by a, yeah. Don't know what those three initials mean. I think you mean Chicago Town. They are the best food company around. !Pizza. Because after all, I am the captain of team Magnificent Meat Feast in the Chicago Town Tournament of Toppings. Free pizza, anyone? Exactly. We all want free pizza. What's the lowest offer you've ever had for a brand deal? Less than 100 quid. And they just got laughed out of town. Yeah, does the shirt not fit? You saw the Instagram post, Scotty. It's a 2XL. It's a bit tight. So yeah, I wore the shirt for as long as I was contractually obliged to, then took it off. People have voted for ham and pineapple. Get out of the stream. A lot of people commented on the Instagram post. Needs pineapple. Need to see how many people have said that now. So many people seem to not understand what makes a good pizza. Yeah, lots of people talking about pizza. If you've got Instagram, by the way, I'd really appreciate you going and liking the post and voting in the poll that's on my story. Because otherwise, if we get like 5,000 people voting in the competition, I've only got 400 likes on the Instagram post, they're going to know that I cheated. But I've got Tubes off of Soccer AM in my group. He's got the ham and bacon thing that's also in my group or whatever it is. So I've got, Tubes has got like 200,000 Instagram followers. I've got to beat Tubes. Not gonna happen, is it? Bad that when I search for LOLLUJO on Insta, Anna comes up first. That is unacceptable. Absolutely unacceptable. Click the ticks, but nothing happens. I don't know. What about some channel points bets for the viewers? Mods, if you want to do channel points bets, knock yourselves out. Should we test how the voting works? So if we go to the thing, I don't actually know how we do it. Because I'm not supposed to vote myself. So there's the link. So you go through here. And then you vote for your winners. The main thing is you vote for Magnificent Meat Feast, because that's my pizza. And then you vote for the worst one in all the other categories, so I've got an easier round in the next round. So if you see a vegan option, you vote for them, because they ain't winning. This one's difficult, because ham and pineapple's grotty, but people will vote out of it. Vote for it, so I think you go loaded cheese there. And then you click cast your votes. At which point, so your vote's counted then. And then if you want to win vouchers, you enter your details in there. And then you can potentially win some vouchers. Just make sure you vote for Magnificent Meat Feast. Right, we need a goal from somewhere. Where's it going to come from? We're not doing too bad, bearing in mind we're doing this without our top scorer from last year, because he plays for them. So we're doing all right. We don't have very many normal midfield players. We've got a lot of attacking midfielders. Was that pizza picture the weirdest photo shoot you talked about? Yeah. Me and Anna sat there for ages trying to, because it was quite a specific brief about the shots they wanted. And we're there posing with a pizza. But by the time those pictures were taken, it was stone cold, which is just the way I like it. I did eat a couple of slices of it. I'm on a diet. I couldn't eat the whole thing. But I had a couple of slices. It's very nice. It actually genuinely is a good pizza, which surprised me, because I don't usually like stuffed crusts. They're usually a bit... But it's stuffed with tomato sauce rather than cheese. I hate cheese stuffed crusts, because I like to let my pizza go cold. It ends up hard like a cheese string in there, because it's not proper cheese. So I thought I wasn't going to like it, because it was stuffed crust. But then I actually had it, and it was really good, because it's tomato stuffed, and it stops the crust getting all dry. Tasty. Very, very tasty. Here we go, boys and girls. I tidied up the office the other day and I found my other bells. I've now lost them again. You don't believe me now, do you? I definitely found the bells. Here they are. I found the jingle bells. Anna will be in a minute. Turn them bells off! New brand deal wasn't as good as the other one last week. The one with the shorts. Ah, that one wasn't a brand deal. I wish it was. I'm still wearing those shorts now. Probably need washing. Oh my word! We're into the semi-final! What a goal! Let's have a little bit of this, boys and girls. So this is against last year's parent club without last year's top scorer. We've just knocked them out of the cup. We're into the semi-final. Well, does this cup have European qualification attached to it? Because we're into the semi-final. Winners qualify for the Europa Conference League. Apparently, the team we've just beaten are ineligible for Europe. So are they another one who were rascals? Are they banned from Europe? How would we find out? It says they're ineligible for Europe. What would make them ineligible other than a ban, surely? I don't know where it would tell us that they're banned. Well, we're still in it. How good was I at football in my prime? Not very. I'm still in my prime anyway. What do you mean? I'm in my prime now. That gives you the context of how good I was in my prime. I still consider myself to be in it. So how good do you think I am now? Probably not very good. Would be my guess. Right. So when's the draw for the next round? Because this, it's a weird cup. We played the first half of the cup last season. So the first round comes in June. It's April now. First round was in June. We played through those first three rounds. And now we're playing the quarterfinals. We've got the semi-final coming up. So I guess the final is in May sometime. Because it gives qualification to Europe. Very strange. Waiting for the Streamer Showdown five-a-side match. I reckon I could take most of them lot. Not, I'm retired from competitive sports. See, here's an example of when we could get Chicago Town on the phone. Another $3,000. Lovely stuff. Thank you. You want me to stick another logo on my shirt? Fine. Sticker on the shirt. Content. Right. Semi-final draw. So, it's us. It's the three biggest teams in the country. Minsk, Shakhtar, Soligorsk, and Barte, which I think are the three favourites. So it's the three biggest teams in the country and us. This is going to be a real good gauge of where we are. So, Barte versus Shakhtar, Minsk versus Smorgon. Actually, that's not the big Minsk. That's mini Minsk. Because there's Minsk and there's Dynamo Minsk. So Dynamo Minsk are the good one. Mini Minsk. And not that much better than us. We're now considered to be the worst team in the league, which is really nice. But why would I terminate the loan for a tight thigh that's going to keep him out of training for one day? In fact, we play Minsk now in the league away from home. That's going to give us a good idea of where we stand against them going into these cup games. We could have a domestic final. Wouldn't that be lovely? So Zealand's face back's been improved, has it? So it works better now. That is interesting. Right. Come on, boys and girls. Let's start our league season with a bang. As we're looking for Champions League within 14 seasons now. Easy. Jamie, welcome back. How are you doing? Right, obviously Chikida comes in after his spectacular goal in the last game. So he's in. Ivanov is in as well, who couldn't play in the last two games because his parent club were Neman Grodno. Neman Grodno. So he's in. Why don't I recognize this guy's name? Came off the bench in the last game. Okay, that's fine. He can play in there. See, I thought he was a striker. He's not. He's a midfielder. We're going to go with this then. Let's see how we compare to Minsk. Could end up being LOLLUJO versus Zealand's former team in the final as Zealand managed Barte in this FM. Yeah, that's why we've got to do the Champions League faster than he did. From a much more difficult starting point. He started with the second best team in the country. I'm starting with a team in the second best league in the country. And we'll win the Champions League as quickly as he did. That's the plan. Right, Scotty is clarifying the bet is for the semi-final, not this league match. They are all against the same opposition. Do I like my new cameras? Sort of. So I've got two new cameras that I've been using on the vlog. I've got this one, which is a Sony ZV-1, which is like the RX100, but more video focused. I like the autofocus on it. The autofocus is so sharp and so quick. But if you've been watching the vlogs lately, the image stabilization on this is not as good as what I was using before, the Canon G7X. But the Canon G7X has a really slow autofocus. Thank you for the sub, Hail the Tail. So I've got to decide which is more infuriating when you're watching. A camera that's often out of focus or a camera that shakes around. Because there doesn't seem to be a little point and shoot camera that is good at both. And this massive rig is too big to carry around with me a lot of the time. This has fantastic autofocus and fantastic image stabilization, but it's big and heavy and you can't really take it around a theme park. So yeah, the image stabilization on this is rubbish. The solution for image stabilization is my other new camera, which is my DJI Mini Pocket or whatever it's called, which is fantastic for image stabilization. But because it's such a small camera and such a small lens and you can't put an external mic on it, it's not ideal for vlogging. It's good for B-roll. I'm still fiddling. You know I like buying new toys. I'll probably still buy new toys. I'll find the perfect solution eventually. I don't own it yet. I don't know that it exists. GoPros are fine. I've got a GoPro, wherever it is. It's probably still in my camera bag. I've had a number of GoPros over the years. They're fine, but you always get, even when you're not on the widest setting, you always have that fisheye feel on a GoPro where you know you're filming on a GoPro and the audio's rubbish on them. So there's no perfect vlogging camera yet. Well, there is. It's this, but it's too big. It might even be this camera, the one that I'm not talking into now, the one I use for my wide shot here, which is a Canon M50, which is a little mirrorless, slightly smaller version of this that's much lighter. That with a wide lens might be perfect. We'll figure it out eventually. How good is NordVPN? It's awesome. I use it on all my devices. Protects you from baddies and allows you to watch Netflix from other countries. Or as I discovered today, it was on a WrestleTalk video, an advert for a different VPN. But I've realized DC have now got their own version of Marvel Unlimited, but it's only available in the US. That has all of the DC comics on. I'm absolutely signing up for that later using my NordVPN to pretend I'm in the US. So it's gonna allow me to read US comics as well. Brilliant. Yeah, you should definitely get yourself a VPN. You need a VPN, full stop. I'd recommend you get NordVPN because I've found it's the best one and it's really good value. But even if you ignore me and don't get NordVPN, for goodness sake, have a VPN. You've got to have a VPN. Just for your own privacy and security. Especially if you're using devices outside. If you're going out using public Wi-Fi in restaurants or trains or pubs or wherever, and you're not using a VPN, why aren't I liking the new Sony? The image stabilization's rubbish. It has got, I forget what it calls it, it's called Steady Shot. And it has a setting that, so I've got it on, hold on, let me find the settings. I know this is really boring if you're not a camera nerd, but we won't be talking about this for long. So the steady shot options are So it's got standard, which is what I've got it on now, which is still shaky. Not as shaky as having it turned off, but especially at the corners of the frame, you notice a lot more shake than you get on the Canon. But if you put it on active steady shot, which eliminates a lot of the shake, it crops the image in so far that I may as well be using my phone. You need a wider lens if you're going to crop it in that far, and you can't change the lens on it. So it's not perfect just yet. Currently 600k in debt in my level 10 save with Armthorpe Welfare. Currently fourth in the National North. Currently hoping to go up and get a board takeover. Yikes. Yeah, you need some pennies. You need a cup run. My Spotify dislikes when I use Nord, but I use it religiously on my phone when I'm public Wi-Fi. That's weird, because I'm using Spotify right now and Nord is on my PC. So I have Nord running. And Spotify, I mean, I'm not pretending to be anywhere else. Nord is running, but I'm in the UK on it. But we're not having any problems running Spotify for the stream. Must just be one of those weird things that glitches sometimes. Yes, that was two disallowed goals and two highlights. Match fixing is still real here in Belarus, apparently. Brewchap, thank you for the sub. And Riggs in Blankets, thank you for the sub as well. Come on, let's have a winner. Based on these first few matches, bearing in mind we've got no tactical familiarity yet, I certainly don't expect to be getting relegated with this team. We look like we're capable of mixing it up with the lesser teams in this division. We've not looked out of our depth in any of these matches yet. We could even still grab a winner here. I'm lost on what kind of save to do, Kev. Any suggestions? Do what I did for this save. Load up all the countries you've not managed in before. Start unemployed and see where you end up. That's how we ended up in Belarus. And then... see, we've lost this when we didn't really deserve to. And then figure it out from there. Do you like the look of the team? If so, you might do it as a road to glory. If they've got good youth setup, you might do a youth academy. If you might do a journeyman. Play around with it. You try one of the A600 series. They're bigger though, aren't they? In which case, I'll stick with my Canon. I much prefer the Canon software. And Canon colour is better. I went for the Sony purely because it was a point and shoot with better autofocus. That's what sold it to me. I just didn't realise the image stabilisation was going to be rubbish. I might just get a gimbal. If I can get a small gimbal, I don't know how big a gimbal is likely to be, but the image, the DJI is so good, I'm tempted to get a DJI gimbal. If I can get a DJI gimbal that's not much bigger than this tripod thing, Sony tripod thing that I've got, so like 5 or 6 inches as a gimbal, and get the image stabilization done that way, then that might be perfect. Because certainly the image quality on a static camera is so much better on that than it is on the Canon equivalent. Matty, thank you very much for the bits. Very kind of you. Surge in Minsk bets after that result. Yeah. So Chiquita's expecting to be loaned out. He needs to remember he's just scored a cracking goal for us. Don't want to loan him out if we're going to be using him. We're getting a lot of money thrown into this club, by the way. We just had 130 grand thrown in again. The board are up to no good. What rep and qualifications did I start with? Lowest of both. So, Sunday League footballer with no coaching badges at all. In fact, we should probably do a coaching course while we've got money in the bank. Now seems like a time to... Come on, board. We've got over a quarter of a million in the bank. They reckon they can't afford for me to do a coaching course. Ridiculous. Just remembered a posh connection. Jason Neal is from my hometown. Congrats on the promotion. Awesome. The board just earned that money off the result. Yeah, with the ref disallowing our goals. Enjoyed the podcast you did with Mr. Deers. Really enjoyed it. Thank you very much. Glad you enjoyed it. I enjoyed doing it. I want to do more stuff like that. rare for someone to ask me to do a podcast. Probably because I just talk constantly the way I did with Diz. He said, we're going to do an hour. We did 2 hours and he had to stop me. I would have kept going. I had lots more to say. If he wants a part two at any point, he knows where to find me. Yeah, I enjoy doing stuff like that. I feel like I have a lot to say and I don't often have people ask. Please do 5-star pod. I mean, you can't just invite yourself onto podcasts. I've never been asked to do 5-star pod. If they ask me, I would probably say yes. Unless they said, come and do it right now, when I was unavailable. That was the major gaming podcast, I know. And I wasn't going to let him re-record that bit either. I made sure to integrate it into the rest of the video. So he couldn't, because it was right at the start, he could have just reshot that bit. Weren't going to have that. Make a gag out of it. Shady! 35 months of tier 3. He's still paying my bills after all these years. Thank you very much, Shady. Hey, Shady, do you like free pizza? Exclamation mark pizza in the chat. Gotta love some free pizza. Or the idea of free pizza, the possibility of free pizza. I'm not guaranteeing anybody free pizza, but some of you might get some free pizza. Ivanov is in. Ivanov is in! 35 months is close to 3 years, isn't it? Let's just get the engage Kev maths for a moment. That's 1 month off of 3 years. Where's Alfie? We need Alfie to do us a new emote. Not a new emote, a new channel icon. You're not going to get a new one at 3 years because no one's ever got there before. So we need a new sub icon to celebrate 3 years. We're in again. Ivanov's unstoppable. We need to sign this boy permanently. I approve of the latest sponsorship deal. Good. I'm glad you approve, Shady. A glitter nut. A diamond nut. A glitter diamond nut. That has to be for 5 years, surely. I remember when we had these nuts made. Alfie did them like a year ago, I think. I remember saying to him at the time, we don't need one for 2 years. No one's ever going to get to 2 years. Here's Shady nearly at 3 years. And now I'm thinking, well, we need one for 5 years now. Madness how long some of you have been around. You won't get it because of the founder's badge. Do you have a founder's badge? Oh, of course he does. Of course he does. Talking of founder's badges, Anna's stream tomorrow should be the last one she needs to get to affiliate. Now, I don't know how long the affiliate onboarding process is now. I don't know if it's automatic or if she has to wait a little bit. But this week, Anna should be getting affiliate. So if people like founders badges, you want to keep an eye on Anna's streams and Anna's Twitter this week. A leather nut for 3 years. How'd you depict leather? Using just colours. I don't get the normal sub icon anyway. I get the founders icon. Are you the only one who's got that founders badge? What does the founders badge mean? Is that just that you were in on that first month? Or you were one of the first however many people. Thanks to LOLLUJO for Belarus. You're welcome. 3 years should be a free Bentos tin. Oh, my word. You were mentioned in Mr. Diz's podcast, kind of. Kev talked about first viewers on Twitch. Exactly. Seems weird. I've been here for 12 months. It's flown by. It has been. It's been weird for me streaming for this long consistently. The first 10 subs get the founders badge. My word. So Shady was in my first 10 subs and he's still around now. Does Kyle have that badge? I don't know. Imagine if Anna turned into an e-girl due to streaming. I don't know what that is. I'm nearly 40. What's an e-girl? Just say long live Belarus. Okay, I'm not going to say that because that feels like politics. I've been here 32 months. Awesome. Wish I could celebrate birthday every day like Nord does. Lucky old Nord. I think we should get rid of any innuendo related to the nuts and change to plums. Why not? Search Belle Delphine. She is an e-girl. That doesn't tell me what an e-girl is. I'm vaguely aware of who Belle Delphine is. Is that just like someone who shows their niblets on the internet? Is that what e-girl means? Someone give me a definition of e-girl. Didn't realize it was first 10 subs. Well, there you go, Shady. Can I just point out we're 4-0 up away from home against a team we just lost to in the league? As much as I want to win this cup, I'd have quite liked to have got the 3 points in the league. This is going to be a big confidence booster. We've got 1 foot in this final already, which is, I mean, that's a step away from Europe then. Anna will be able to sell her bathwater. I mean, she doesn't take baths, so I don't know how she'll do that. I don't think it's made its way into the Oxford Dictionary yet. Yeah, but it'll be in the Urban Dictionary, surely. Between the lot of you, you must be able to muster up a definition. Ah! It's sort of highly sexualized woman on the internet profiting off that sort of thing. Look, if Anna wants to do that, she can do that. Money's money. The e-girl and e-boy is a niche fashion trend or aesthetic that emerged at the end of the 2010s. It's almost exclusively seen on online social media. In particular, it's most often seen as a persona depicted on a video sharing application, TikTok. That still doesn't explain what it is, though, does it? What is it, though? I hate things that don't have a definition. You just know. If you know, you know. Well, I don't know, so tell me. Yeah, but if you know, you know. Yeah, but well, explain it to me then, because I don't know. Basically, a girl online making money from just being a girl. Fair enough, as far as I'm concerned. Weird female influencer who sells themselves out by doing whatever creepy men want. I would say that's quite a harsh definition. Sells themselves out. They're just making money. You lot are sat there giving me money for playing a video game that you like. I don't see how it's any different from you giving a girl money because you like her niblets. It's the same. You like a certain thing about me. People like certain things about these girls. As far as I'm concerned, it's all fair game. People can make money however they want to make money. If there's a market for it, who's to say anyone shouldn't exploit it? Yeah, I got paid to drink water. I'm a definite e-dad. What's an e-dad? Just popping by to show my face. We'll catch you all later. Toodle pip, Shady. I scared Shady away talking about my niblets. Exactly. You're not seeing my niblets. You can basically see them in the Chicago Town photo. The shirt's so tight. The term e-girls and e-boys are slang terms for young women and men, respectively, who are active internet users, often stereotyped as emo-styled anime and gaming fans trying to get attention on social media. Well, that's basically what both me and Anna are already then. Well, I think we're probably both a bit... Are you an e-girl? He's asleep. He's had a stressful day, isn't he? Anna, people want to know if you're going to become an e-girl. What is an e-girl? Apparently it's not her. Are you going to get your niblets out on the internet? She's gone. Niblets sounds like a spicy bar snack. Well, niblets are what the individual corn pieces are on sweet corn. If you get a can of sweet corn... Oh, hold on. Ah, pressed the wrong button. I've not gone anywhere. If you get a can of sweet corn, I mean, I'm proving it to you. I don't feel like I need to, but I'm going to. So green giant sweet corn. I think you'll find these are referred to as niblets. I need a picture. I used to say niblets on the can. Not knob. No, not knob. Niblets. They must... Do they not say niblets on the can anymore? I'm horrified. There you go. Extra sweet niblets. Got some extra sweet niblets. Niblets. A niblets. That's what a niblet is. So if I was an e-girl, would I have extra sweet niblets? Is that how it works? Green giant niblets. Whole kernel golden corn. Love niblets. That's what niblets are. LOLLUJO sponsored by Green Giant Niblets. I would love that. That would make my year. The amount, I mean, again, that would be a perfect integration. Every 20 minutes of the stream. Who wants to see my niblets? And I just hold up a pile of corn. Oh, Kev's got his niblets out again. Would be amazing. Put your niblets away, Kev. Never. If I mentioned the dick pic today. No. So if Green Giant are watching, I want to promote your niblets. I'm a little bit disappointed that niblets doesn't seem to be on the can in the UK anymore. Certainly was 20 years ago when I started saying niblets. Now I feel like a bit of a buffoon. We got a talk in college today about checking for testicle irregularities. Nice. I mean, it's never too soon to start checking your niblets. I check mine every Sunday morning in the shower. Get in there and have a proper rummage around in my ball bags. Niblets is a small piece of food, in particular a kernel of sweet corn. There's a pea niblet as well, then. As to sell chicken niblets, that seems wrong. There's no such thing as a chicken niblet. I'm not having it. You just Google niblets, all the pictures are Green Giant cans. Good. I'm not Googling niblets. You never know what's going to show up. I don't know if Green Giant exists anymore. You what? Green Giant must exist. They exist. Don't you worry. Where to buy? That's about to put a map on the screen, so let's hide that. Don't want people seeing where I live. For Anna to become a true e-girl, she'd need to start an OnlyFans and do hot tub streams. I think I'm more likely to do both of those things than Anna is. Green Giant probably keeps going by selling pictures of his niblets online. I'm up for it. Oh, that's a bad penalty miss. Green Giant extra sweet corn niblets. I want some extra sweet corn. You can be an e-girl without those things, just need the right spirit. That sentence makes no sense to me at all. I mean, neither me or Anna like anime. Does that rule us out? We do go to Comic-Con, though, but we don't do cosplay. We're both big gamers. Obviously, these days, I'm more just Football Manager. I do like Persona. As does Anna. And Anna's big into like Persona, Final Fantasy, that kind of thing. Don't have to like it, just say you do. It's the winged eyeliner that you need. I've never worn eyeliner, I don't think. Actually, that's probably not true. Is that the one you do with a pencil? When the girls did my makeup a few years ago, they attacked me with a pencil. I think I have worn eyeliner, briefly. It's just uncomfortable having it put on. But then I guess it's someone else poking a stick in your eye, effectively. It's going to feel a little bit unusual. When's the next It Takes Two stream? Good question. Don't know. I'm hopefully going to have my PS5 permanently plumbed into my PC by the end of the week. So at the moment, I have to unplug my gaming PC and faff around the back of it. We had to stream the PS5, which is, it's me who's causing the holdup. So maybe this week, maybe next week. We are definitely going to play through and finish it, just not anytime soon. Oh, that's disallowed, thank goodness. I'd quite like Anna to have affiliate by the time that happens. So the next time I send a whole bunch of people over, you can all go there with your Twitch Primes. Or a fiver in hand. Anna, have a fiver! Persona is anime, Final Fantasy is now. Yeah, but I don't watch the anime. I play the game. I've never watched... The only anime I've ever watched is Death Note. Because I liked the books. I've tried watching other anime and just don't really get it. I tried watching Attack on Titan. I even tried reading the books. Didn't like it either way. Have you played Astro's Playroom on PS5? Anna has. I haven't. I played it very briefly. My next Prime sub, you and Anna are going to have to battle it out for the sub. I'm bigger than her. I'll batter her. To be honest, I don't have time for anime. I don't really want to get into it. I watch enough wrestling. Wrestling's my weird, nerdy thing. I don't need anime as well. Wrestling and comic books, the two of them is plenty. No, I've never watched Pokemon, ever. I've played all the games, but I've never watched it. I remember walking around Comic-Con, and they were playing the Pokemon theme song, and everyone I was with started singing along. I'm like, I never saw this. I'm too old for this. But I was like 18 when Pokemon first became a thing. And I didn't have any of the channels to watch this stuff on. I didn't grow up with like Sky or cable or anything as a kid. I never got all that until I was an adult and moved out. Yeah, wrestling's basically real life anime, exactly. It's wrestling superheroes. Watch some Studio Ghibli films. Anna keeps trying to get me to do that, but... I played that game, Ni No Kuni. I liked that. That's Studio Ghibli, isn't it? Is it Ghibli or Ghibli? I don't even know. But I've never watched any of their stuff. I like Sackboy on PS5 when Anna was streaming, especially when Kev was telling Anna to turn the music off. I had to. She was going to get DMCA'd. Do I like Naruto? No. I bought like the first three Naruto books at Comic-Con one year because I was told, this was after I'd gone through Death Note. I only read Death Note in the last 4 or 5 years. And someone said, right, go and do Naruto next. If you're gonna get into manga, next stop Naruto. And tried it, couldn't get into it. Tried Attack on Titan, couldn't get into it. I've got lots of half-started. I think I've still got a Naruto book behind me on the shelf somewhere. I'm more likely to read the books than I am to watch the anime. So I read a lot of comic books as it is. So it fits into my schedule easier to just add comic books into the mix than to try and find an extra bit of time to sit and watch cartoons that I don't really have. Sometimes I don't even get to watch all the wrestling. I don't watch any WWE wrestling anymore because I'm too... AEW takes up all of my time. Certainly don't have time to add more watching stuff in. Is there anything you recommend to anyone and everyone? What, just of anything? Football Manager. I don't know. That's a good question. I just don't really have a good answer for it. You should write an autobiography and record an audiobook of it. Who would want that? I'm 38 and I've done nothing. It would be the dullest autobiography ever. I basically told you my life story on Dizzy's podcast. There wasn't much to it, was there? Did a few jobs, had some kids. Doesn't really have an ending yet. Where can I watch AEW in the UK? It's on ITV, I think. I've got AEW Plus on Fight TV, so I can watch it all live or live replay, like replays the next morning. I think it's on ITV at like 1 a.m. on a Friday or something, or Sunday, or Certainly it's on ITV somewhere. That's your best starting point. We've just scored another goal. We're going to this final, boys and girls. Am I going to watch Loki on Wednesday? I won't watch it on Wednesday. I will watch it. The Rummy, thank you very much for the sub. I haven't finished watching the Winter Soldier one yet. I've only watched like the first three of those. Because me and Anna and Amy watched WandaVision because we were all into that. But Amy got really into the Winter Soldier one, so watched it without me. And Anna wasn't interested at all. And I just don't have time to sit and watch stuff on my own. But I think Loki we'll all be interested in, so we'll all want to watch that. But I need to have caught up with the story so far first. So at some point in the next week, I need to watch the Winter Soldier thing so that I'm ready for Loki. But I am looking forward to Loki. It's going to be awesome. Is Falcon and the Winter Soldier any good? Not really. Certainly not what I've seen so far. But I feel like, I'm assuming by the end of it, Falcon is Captain America, would be my guess. I need to see how he gets there. I like Winter Soldier as a character. It always, I always upset my kids because they're, both the girls are really, really into the Winter Soldier. They're big Sebastian Stan fans. So I always play up the time I was in the same green room at Comic-Con as Sebastian Stan. Didn't speak to him. I'm too shy to speak to anyone like that, but it always upsets them that I was in the same place as him. Could have said hello, didn't say hello. Falcon and the Winter Soldier is like a watered down version of The Boys. The Boys is great. But I haven't watched it all yet because, again, it's one of those things that we can't watch when Andy's around because it's hideously violent. Me and Anna want to watch it together, but I'm busy in the evening, she's busy during the day, so we just haven't got around to finishing watching it. But I bought the comics. The comics are weird, but good. Invincible is brilliant. I did watch through all of that because I loved the Invincible comics. Invincible is really good. It's one of my favorite comics. So yeah, I watched all of Invincible. Invincible was excellent. Right, we're now 2-1 down after 20 minutes, 5-3 on aggregate. We need to make sure we don't throw this away after being in such a strong position. We've got our first final of the save coming up. Oh, Ivanov! What a man, his sixth goal of the season already. Do I like In the Night Garden? Nope. No, I do not. This is only the third stream we've done on this save. We started in the second tier and we're half a match away from our first domestic final. I really am very good at football. Very good at Football Manager. Very good looking, very good at Football Manager. We're making minced meat of them. Oh, Scotty. Oh, I can't decide if that's wonderful or terrible. I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt. Come on, lads. Let's have another one before halftime. Finish them off. We score here. They're done. Oh, I thought we had. Oh, that was so close. 2-2 at halftime. They'll fancy being able to turn this ship around. Oh, did I do a team talk there? I clicked on it, but I don't think it registered. But it then didn't give me that. Are you sure you don't want to do... blah, 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 blah. So I think we did a team talk. I haven't upset everybody, so I assume we did. Right, substitution o'clock. Everyone is so tired again. We have a couple of substitutes who can come on. Come on, boys. Here we go. Next goal wins. We're in the highest division now, yeah. We got promoted in our first season. We're now in the top flight. And this is the semi-final of the cup. Oh, God. We're 15 minutes to go. This is... See, I don't know. Do I demand more here? Or are the players going to be like, we're 6-4 up. What are you demanding more for? This is one of those things where you don't really know how they're going to respond. Yeah, sad faces. They didn't respond great. But hopefully we're going to hold on. I'm just not going to make a change. Just hands on the head. Hands on the head. Don't touch anything. My brain doesn't say I'm 42. My body insists that I am. Seamus, you are telling me. All this nonsense at the moment. The fact I have a cardiologist now. I'm 38. I feel like a teenager. Unacceptable that I'm apparently an adult. I'm closer to retirement than I am to primary school. Is that right? I retire early. Right, we are facing Shakhtar Soligorsk in the final, who are reigning champions and currently top of the league. That's going to be a tricky game. When do we play them? Ages, yeah. That won't be on tonight's stream. That'll be tomorrow night. But now we've got a massive league game. We're away against foreign Arsenal, who finished below us in the league below last year. This is a must-win game. I'm 18 and I'm starting to feel old. Weird, because I'm 38 and I've never felt old. What time am I live until tonight? We'll stop at 10. I've got to edit the vlog. I've got to edit home video as well. I've got a few bits left to do. It's been a little bit of a culture shock going back onto full schedule again today after a week of not doing it. Not really streaming last week and only doing half the videos. I know we did a lot of going out and doing stuff, but I also did a lot of sitting in a chair and not really doing anything. Anna was saying last week wasn't a rest. For me, it really was. I played a lot of Mass Effect. I read a lot, sat around a lot. I had a lovely week. Apart from the few issues we had with Andy. Have I done a sponsorship with the chair? This chair? Yeah. Although the discount isn't available anymore, I don't think. It was only for a month. Yeah, this chair was a sponsorship thing. I'm only feeling old because there's now professional football players younger than me. Well, I now am in the situation where everyone who plays for my team is younger than me. I still remember the day there was a player younger than me for the first time. I feel like it was Matthew Everington. Let's check his date of birth. I think he was the first one who was younger than me. Oh no, he's older than me. So who would it have been? Could it have been Jimmy Bullard? No, he's even older. Who would it have been? I was convinced it was Matthew Everington. I don't know who it was then. I remember that feeling. That was the day I stopped standing behind the goal and started sitting in the family stand. But now they're all younger than me. Right, let's go win this football match. Must win against foreign Arsenal. I was convinced it was Everington. Let's play who looks older. Oh, I definitely look younger than Matthew Everington. These days. If you reckon I look older than this guy. I mean, I look younger than he does then, but if you look at him now, I need a recent picture of him. I I definitely look younger than that guy, right? I remember him playing for Posh as a 15-year-old. But I am definite. I definitely look younger than him. I am younger than him. Because I am younger. Only by a year. I'm not going to look that old in a year's time. Give me no. Definitely look younger than him. My beard is better than his, exactly. And my new eye cream has been doing wonders for the bags under my eyes. I noticed it when I did a TikTok earlier. My bags are noticeably less noticeable. It could be because I spent all last week getting enough sleep. It's either that or the new eye cream. But either way, the bags and the lines around my eyes are very minimized now. Favorite one was Kev versus Zoella. I definitely look younger than Zoella as well. What new eye cream? I don't even know, Charlotte Tilbury, is that a thing? Hold on, I need to check now. Why are the buttons not working? What's going on with my keyboard? Charlotte Tilbury eye cream. One of the, it looks like that one, proper girly. It's not that one, but it's in that kind of jar. Can't remember exactly which one it is. That's the one, Magic Eye Rescue. What an advert for Charlotte Tilbury I am. Still waiting for the Kev cookbook. It's on the to-do list. Don't you worry. People who've just joined are so confused. Nah, they're not. Unless they're completely new. They know what I'm like. Was it Craig McCall Smith, the player that you're older than? Just, I was long before his time. It was like early, it would have been an early 2000s player. McCall Smith didn't turn up until like 2007, 8-ish. It was long before him. Charlotte Tilbury could be the next channel sponsor. I don't know if they'd want me as the face for their eye cream. Usually you pay someone who doesn't need eye cream to be the face for eye cream. You don't want someone who actually needs it to represent you. No, there's no points deductions this season, I don't think. I tell you what, we're better than this lot now. They've not upgraded much since last season, have they? Mark Tyler's definitely older than me. It's probably some obscure Posh player who no one else will remember. It could have been Tony Shields. No, he's older than me. It could have been Jamie Day. I did his mortgage. I'm certain he's younger than me. See, he's much younger than me, so it wouldn't have been him. It would be someone. So, Peterborough United squad 2001, let's say. Do we have the squad from this season? So, who could it have been? It wasn't Drury. Wasn't Gill, I don't think. Dan Connor probably was younger than me, but I wouldn't have counted him. It would have been someone who was playing, really. It could have been Jellyman, actually. We'll check Gareth Jellyman. Another Championship Manager legend. No, he's younger than me. Older than me, sorry. It wasn't Gill, surely. So maybe it was the following year. We need to find out who it was now. is more important than the stream, I'm afraid. And that's, we've gone back a year now. Right. Come on, are you going to give me this squad or not? So, who could it have been? Sean St. Ledger, guarantee, would have been younger than me. Adam Newton did his mortgage as well. Got around this team a bit. Sean St. Ledger. Could it have been him? He's younger than me. It could have been him. Could have been him. Maybe. Who knows? Yeah, Jellyman's a real name. Gareth Jellyman was a championship manager legend. He was one of those hot wonder kids that you had to buy out of that posh team. It was the year after Etherington and Davies. He basically, even though he was a left back, he basically replaced Etherington in our team when we sold him to Spurs. We played Jellyman in front of Drury. Me, it was being too old to be a hot prospect for the future on FM. Wow. He's the guy who Jeff Stelling named his book after, Jellyman's Thrown a Wobbly. That is a great name for a book. I didn't know that was a name for a book, but that is a great name for a book. Presumably he said that on telly at some point, did he? Do-do. So, boys and girls, you're in for a real treat this week, because not only am I streaming tonight, I'm also streaming tomorrow night. Two nights in a row. This is unheard of in this new world where I vlog again. But we'll stream tomorrow night as well. We've got to get a few streams in this week so you don't yell at me too much for doing Raid Shadow Legends later in the week. Towards the end of the week, we've got a Raid Shadow Legends stream. So I'll get in plenty of Football Manager either side of it, so that the Raid one doesn't sting as much. I know you love a Raid stream. You like Kev to be able to pay his bills. Boston signed Jellyman on loan when he was young, then brought him back to be captain in his 30s. Nice. Hydrate. It's basically nothing in this now. I'm effectively just drinking my own spit at this point. Video was glitchy from say, yeah, I don't know what that's about. I don't know if it's a YouTube thing or what. It's only the first 5 minutes or so. I could have taken it down, but then I wouldn't have been able to get it back up again today because I was doing a transfer special and I had to get the Chicago Town thing done and I knew I was streaming. So I just figured leave it up. No, tomorrow's one's fine. I've watched tomorrow's one through. When's the next streamer showdown? July, I think. There's not one this month because of the Euros. All the matches were a bit glitchy. It's just one of those things. There's nothing I can do about it now. Just shut your eyes and listen to it. I described the game so beautifully. It's like listening to the radio. Like I said, I don't know what caused it. But the videos for tomorrow are fine. When's my next car wash trip? No idea. Do you think my car needs washing then? You say my car's dirty? Don't be looking at my car. Are you outside now? If you're out there now, give it a polish yourself. Except you, who do you think is the best FM player? Plates, because he's won the showdown twice. That's how you judge it. It's easy. Just judge it by who's won the most showdowns. So I'm comfortably better than everybody else. Plates is a little bit better than everyone else apart from me, but nowhere near as good as I am. There's a few of them that are all right, and the rest of them are rubbish. Easy. That's how you work it out. Have I ever played FIFA? I've played FIFA since the 90s. It's the mid-90s. Since before most of you were born. No, I've not got the old car anymore. I sold that months ago now. Ben just turns up because he helps run the streamer. I mean, Ben doesn't help run the streamer showdown. He runs the streamer showdown. Back when FIFA was good. I mean, anyone who's telling me FIFA was good in 1995 and it's not now, didn't play it in 1995. It was trash back then. It was awful. Whereas this year, it's fine. I enjoy it. It's a perfectly good game. Would you like a game that's FIFA's gameplay, but everything else is like FM? No. They're two very different games. Wouldn't want them to be combined. FIFA, you got to remember, FIFA was so bad in the late 90s, early 2000s, that FIFA was just what you played because it had the licenses, but what you really enjoyed playing was ISS or Sensible Soccer or something else like that. International Superstar Soccer, the precursor to Pro Evo, was so much better. Up until like Xbox 360 era, PES was so much better than FIFA. It was only from like 2006 onwards that FIFA became the dominant football game. As much as people bitch and moan about Ultimate Team, it's a combination of Ultimate Team and YouTube that became FIFA the monster that it is now, the huge game that it is now. That's a combination of Ultimate Team and YouTube. You take Ultimate Team and YouTube away, and FIFA is nowhere close to the level that it's at. I've just cursed. Fairly confident I didn't. What did I say? What's the point in FM having FIFA graphics, the amount of time and money it would take when you spend 80% of the menus? Exactly. Plus, you get into the uncanny valley then, don't you? Like this, you can... It's still just abstract enough for you to be able to squint a little bit, use your imagination and pretend it's a real football match. If it's got FIFA graphics, I don't think it's as good. That's a good header. Everyone played PES 6 and FIFA 08 the year after, then FIFA took over. Yeah, so that coincides with FIFA getting big on YouTube. And then when was Ultimate Team? 2010? 2009, 2010? When did Ultimate Team start? FIFA was always better online than PES. 09. Well, there you go then. So you might, as much as you might want to moan about Ultimate Team, if you love FIFA, it's as big as it is because of Ultimate Team and YouTube. Ultimate Team was DLC in 09, permanent from 10 onwards. Can I lower the background music a little? I can lower it ever so slightly. The only problem is if I take it down too far, you'll be able to hear my fan, and that'll be more annoying than the music, even if you don't like the music. Oh, hold on. We've got the age limit thing. Have we got any kids we can bring on? I'll just leave that defender on. That's probably the easiest thing to do. We need more midfield players, like proper central midfield players. We've got lots of attacking midfielders. We've not got many who can play just normal central midfield. New cop, thank you for the sub. '11 when FUT got big. Same time KSI and NEP started getting big. Yeah, it all came together. That's why we That's why we need Football Manager to come out with their own version of it this year. Not like a copy of Ultimate Team, but their own thing that takes over the world. Football Manager's in this really brilliant, unique position where if they do an online game right and have it so that it integrates with the mobile version and you can get kids playing it in playgrounds, Football Manager could and bring a slot along with it. And in 10 years' time, it'll be me boxing on the internet as a 50-year-old. Alfie, we were just talking about you an hour ago.
Something that takes 27 months but couldn't. Smiley face.
We thank you for 27 months. We need new sub icons. Shady's about to hit 3 years. We don't have one for 3 years. I don't like Ultimate Teams. Unless you grind for hours or are really good, you have to spend too much money. Yeah, but ultimately it's the thing, ultimately, pun not intended, it is the thing that keeps the game going for 12 months a year. As much as you still get people who like career mode, I never used to play it all year round. But if it wasn't for the fact I don't have time because I'm making Football Manager content, I used to play Ultimate Team through the summer. I'd still be playing it this time of year. You've got new content constantly flowing into the game. So it's Ultimate Team that keeps the game alive. FM version of the Sidemen. We don't all have to live in the same house, do we? We've all got families. Make some more, possibly gonna have to be multi-nuts. I'm up for multi-nuts. The new gens. Oh god, that's horrible. That's horrible. Can you imagine? Get that trademark now, somebody. Tournament years like this with the Euros always keep it going, do it going as well during the summer months. Yeah, I guess. It's a weird one with it being the tournament this summer, because the last time we had a tournament summer was obviously 3 years ago, so my channels were much smaller then, and I don't really know what impact it's going to have on the channel this summer. So I'm not really doing anything specific for the Euros. So it could go one of two ways. It could absolutely kill the channel for a month, because everyone who would be watching my videos at 4 o'clock will be watching the Euros instead. Or it could just increase interest in football generally. I mean, you don't have that summer lull where there's no football. I don't really know what's going to happen. So I don't really know what views are going to look like for the next month. It's all very interesting. I'm not going to do a Euro series, he says now. If I'm getting no views in a month, in like 2 weeks' time, you can guarantee I'll have a Euro series. As you don't watch modern football, will I be watching the Euros? I'll watch the England games. And any that are on while I'm streaming, I'll have them on in the background so we can chat about them. I won't sit there and watch all the matches like some people do, though. I really don't see the appeal of doing that. I find it really hard to get into football matches where I don't care who wins. Just become one of those YouTubers that suddenly starts becoming England's biggest fan and do videos about every game that they know more than the coaches. Oh, believe me, I probably will. I think it would be mad for me to not make videos or streams or something that are related in some way. People will want to know my thoughts. Maybe, I don't know. Devil Muppet, thank you for the sub. I'm just saying, I've been really enjoying your vlogs lately. So much respect for you guys from watching your day tonight. No, thank you very much. I'd still watch, but maybe not when the vids actually come out, when there's games on. Yeah, see, that's the thing. I'll give it a week and we'll see how things are going. What you might find, if views are massively down for the Euros, I might drop down to one video a day like I did last week and just slow the pace down a little bit. Because there's no point in me busting my backside to do two videos a day if no one's watching him or not many people are watching him. So we'll see how it goes. I'll make a judgment after the first week or so. And we'll see how it's getting on. Do a predictions video based on 90s knowledge. That'd be brilliant. Maybe change the times so they don't clash with games. Well, 11 a.m. and 4 p.m. don't clash with games anyway, do they? The games are at 2, 5 and 8. I've done my research. So the 11 o'clock videos don't clash with anything. The 4 p.m. videos come out between your 2 p.m. and your 5 p.m. kickoff. There are no 4 p.m. kickoffs. Catching up on the vlog, Drayton Manor do have a disability access pass. I saw someone get one ahead of me in the queue and I went, when was that though? The vlog will clash, yeah, but that doesn't matter. I don't think there's much overlap between my vlog audience and football. Bearing in mind, the vlog came out yesterday at the same time England kicked off and it was the most viewed video I've put out in like 2 weeks. So, yeah, I think the vlog we don't need to worry about. Remember, it's largely a completely different audience on the vlog channel. I know a lot of you lot will probably watch the vlog because you're the few hundred people who overlap and you're the mad ones who watch everything I do. Some of you. I know some of you won't necessarily watch the vlog. But the vast majority of the vlog audience don't even know what Football Manager is. I had some, when I was tweeting about buying an England shirt the other day, I had someone ask what an England shirt is. That they're obviously a vlog viewer. That shows, I mean, I guess they're in the US or something and the terminology of it's a little bit weird. They've just never heard someone talk about football stuff before. Realistically, Alfie, I don't think we're going to be going back to Drayton Manor. It was fine, but it was quite a small park. There wasn't really much. It felt a little bit like they had a couple of nice miniature railways, and then the rest of it was a bit like being at Skegness. It didn't feel like a theme park, really. For the price you pay to get in, I mean, it's roughly equivalent price to going somewhere like Legoland. And for the money, I'd much rather go to Legoland. Legoland's brilliant. I don't think it's value for money compared to something like that. And it can't, even with the discount for Andy got in on a disability ticket, Anna got in as a carer. Even with that, for the three of us, it was like 85 quid, I think, for the day. I don't think it's worth 85 quid. Oh yeah, the guy who drove the Thomas train was brilliant. I don't even remember the last English shirt I bought. No, I haven't bought one for a long time, but I figured Andy might like one. Shirt with his name on the back. Then I priced them up and soon decided against that idea when I realized how much it was going to cost. We are doing very well. We might actually qualify for Europe this year, even if we don't win the cup. We've had a very good start to the season. I haven't been probably 15 years straight, Manor. From your vlog, looks like half the rides have gone. I only saw one roller coaster, which I don't know what it was called. I only saw one roller coaster, I think. See, I've never been to Chessington either. Maybe we'll do Chessington as well. The best thing for me, well, there were two good things. The trains were great. The zoo was great. Which was, I mean, that was enough for what we wanted. But I think if you were going there to do a lot of rides, I think you'd be disappointed, especially with Alton Towers just being down the road. I think if you want to do rides, which presumably is why they're not competing with rides, because they're not going to compete with Alton Towers for rides. They need to offer something a little bit different. Right. What time is it? I think we're going to call the stream here. We might do, I don't know, one more game. Should we do one more game, maybe? Maybe we'll do one more game. How does that line us up for tomorrow night? Yeah, we'll do one more game. We'll do one more game. One more game. Then we're going to call it a night. And then tomorrow night, we'll get the final. And continue. These seasons are so short. We could potentially get through most of the rest of the season tomorrow night. Qualify for Europe one way or the other. Yorkshire Wildlife Park just had a huge expansion. Yorkshire Wildlife Park is where he had his biggest meltdown ever, pretty much. We're never going back to that place. A loyal royal, thank you very much for the sub. That puts us to 399 subs. We're ending the stream after this next game. We're going to hit 400 subs before we do. Chessington also has a zoo. Rides are solid. Not a lot of big thrill rides. We don't do them. Good for the family. Definitely had a disability access pass. I think what we kind of decided is we're probably not going to go anywhere else like that until COVID restrictions are lifted a little bit. Because, oh, Scotty's there with a gifted sub. Thank you very much. That gets us to 400. What a hero. It wasn't the lack of disability access pass necessary, because we've done theme parks lots of times with no disability access pass. He doesn't mind queuing if he can see what he's queuing for. It was having to queue to get into Thomas Land and then having to queue again for the rides in there. And that restriction was only in place because of COVID. Like, the train was only running one way because they had to run it back empty and give it a good clean and all that kind of stuff. So while they've got those big restrictions on, I don't think we'll go to anywhere new that we don't know really well. Like, Legoland's a safe trip. We know Legoland. We've been there since COVID's been a thing. We went there last summer. And we, you can enjoy a day at Legoland without going on any rides. Legoland's brilliant just for the Lego. So I think we'll probably do Legoland at some point. I think we'll probably do a holiday in the summer very similar to last summer's one, when we went and had that week down in London and did Legoland while we were down there and rode the tube around. And this year we've got, thanks to Alfie, we've got a letter to wave when we go in the O2 saying he's allowed to film in here, leave us alone. So we can take him down to do the O2 properly. Emily, thank you for the sub.
You're safe with any Merlin parks and COVID.
Yeah, we actually looked into getting Merlin passes again. We had them a few years ago, but I don't think they're selling new ones. I think they're only doing renewals, which is a shame. Because if we, again, if we're going down to London, we'll want to do the London Eye. But yeah, you can only buy the one that isn't valid in August, which is useless. We'd want the gold one, but you can only renew them. They're not selling new gold ones. This one's just a bit pointless for us because you have to go, it's only all the off-season dates and we want to go and do two or three things in the middle of London. It's the geek one. Thank you for the sub. God, that letter's still useful. I mean, we're hoping it'll be useful. We've not been since we've had it. I hope it'll be useful. If we get there and they're like, well, this means nothing, then we'll be a bit grumpy. I walked past you as I was walking into Drayton Manor. I was scared to come up to you as I didn't want to affect your family with Andy. Don't ever worry about saying hello. We love it. Strokes the ego. This is another game against our former parent club. Be nice to pick up one more win to end the stream. Do I still carry business cards? I haven't had business cards for years. I realised how dumb they were. Business cards were important when I had to introduce myself as LOLLUJO and no one could find me. Now I've got a channel with my own name on. I can just say I do YouTube. I'm called Kevin Chapman. Search for that on YouTube. You'll find me. So much easier. It's one of the reasons why that's the channel name. Oh, it'll work. Trust me. You got the Fast Lady's phone number. Brilliant stuff. Good work, Alfie. You should be my my assistant. I can't pay you, and I want you to do it full time. But other than that, it's a great opportunity. Think of the exposure, Alfie. Think of the exposure. Work for experience. Yeah, Alfie, be my intern. When you turn 16, Alfie, you can be my intern. This is where he tries to make out he's an adult already. Need help with pronunciation? No, I'm very good at it. Very good. Oftentimes I find other people say stuff wrong, but my way is always right. Watching an old video from last year and he ate popcorn chicken. I was wondering if he eats popcorn chicken. What, Alfie? No, Alfie's vegetarian. Oh dear, you can tell it's hit 10 o'clock. I'm turning into a troll. Can't help myself at this point. Would Andy like a Three Lions print that I've illustrated? I mean, to be honest, he's not really interested in football or anything like that. I mean, you never know for sure whether he's going to like something, but I wouldn't want you to go to any effort and be offended or upset if he's like, I don't care about this, because that could well be the reaction. Yes, this is the last game of the stream. It looks like we're going to end the stream on a defeat as well, which is always sad when this happens. Of course, I should have expected it, because we can't play Ivanov. And we should know by now that we're a one-man team, and that one man is their player. So we're always going to struggle against them, because we don't have him. We need to sign him permanently next year. Shouldn't have played one more game. At least we've got this out of our system now, so we don't start tomorrow night's stream being sad. We don't want to be sad tomorrow. Tomorrow will be a happy stream where we'll win a cup and then qualify for Europe. As it is, we're still in that top five, which is a different colour for some reason. I can't believe there's five European qualification spots in this league, so I doubt we're going to find out what the different shade of positions is for. Sometimes it's just a little bit odd. Love those pizza photos. Glad you enjoyed them, Alfie. Took us like an hour to do that photo shoot. They were so specific about what they wanted. Watching an old video from last year, Andy ate popcorn chicken. I mean, he's never really eaten much of it. He'll have a little nibble of it. He doesn't really eat the chicken. He likes it breading on anything, really, so he'll have a little bit. Right, that'll do for tonight, boys and girls. We'll be back tomorrow night, 7-ish. Can't guarantee exactly 7 because Sky might not work still. In which case, we'll have problems with Andy watching his bedtime hour again. But we'll wrap things up there for now. You want to be in by like 20 past 7 tomorrow for the Belarusian Cup final. But until then, shall we find somebody to raid? Who are we going to raid? Let's see who's on, shall we? So we'll go to twitch.tv. See who's playing Football Manager. Fraud Dan's on. We're going to raid him. Go and tell him he's a fraud. Dan's in the Kev fan club now. He knows I'm the best. Make him say it. Make him admit that Kev is the greatest. Kevy six times. See you tomorrow, folks. Toodle pip.